By now, I am sure you have heard that there is something called a total media blackout that is supposed to happen because of what happened yesterday. And now, so many journalist friends of mine have been arguing about this blackout. How does it work? What does it mean? But I'm going to start by reading for you the statement from the Human Rights Network for Journalists, which is one of the associations that Apple was talking about, what they define as their total media blackout. And they're saying about 8 actions, but very first one, slap a total media blackout on all activities of or by the Uganda Police Force until the DPC Mwesigye is punitive action is taken. Okay, grammar, but it's okay. This blackout starts with immediate effect, then demands that the Police Disciplinary Committee suspends the DPC with immediate effect and commences investigations, and so many and so many. I'll go up to 8. 8 says, the victims should not cut backdoor deals with the Uganda Police Force because this undermines justice, frustrates those volunteering legal and professional services, and doesn't act as a deterrent for other officers. Do you think this media blackout or this press release is going to get any traction? Do you see any media houses other than the TV station where the journalist worked?
Starting with one which says slap a ban.
Total media blackout.
Total media blackout. From those said, it is not sustainable. It's not.
Why is it sustainable?
Because Mwesigye, who battered a journalist, has been arrested.
Yes.
How will the public get to know about that? When the Kampala North Metropolitan Police Commander arrested him, he arraigned him before the investigation's boss at CPS. Mm-hmm. And that is a police activity.
Okay.
Now, if that does happen, how do you want the public to know about that?
Maybe what they should do is define the punitive action, because they say until punitive action is done.
I mean,
maybe that's enough. Okay. I don't know.
I don't want to sound different from what my colleagues, because all the people who have written the release are my friends and my colleagues' friends. But if that's what they are calling for, I'm sorry to say that some media houses will not go by with that. Because in doing journalism, we are led by what we call editorial policies, editorial lines.
Okay.
We draw different lines given what your media house wants to achieve.
Okay.
Now, the gentleman has been arrested. You want people not to know about that. Even when he's arraigned in court, you do not want to people to know about that. Now, assault, like I told you, what happened was so bad, and assault is chargeable in Uganda laws. Now, if Mwesigye is taken to court, he will be charged. You know, the victim will either, has options.
Including cutting backdoor deals?
I don't know.
Which the press release statement is discouraging. But
the victim can decide to sue the Attorney General. Mm. He can decide to sue Mwesigye as an individual. There are still other ways of how we can have this resolved without totally calling for.
That's at the victim level. But
let me tell you something. Yeah. Now, as an editor, I cannot go by the ban, because as I speak to you now, I've already worked on a story which has gone up. Because he has been arrested. That's what people want to know.
So you're a traitor, maybe. As journalists, they will look at you and say, you're one of the people that is facilitating, directly or indirectly, you're facilitating this police brutality, because if they do it and nothing happens,
no, I just want to make it clear.
Yes.
That although I've worked on the story that has gone up online,
yes,
it does not mean that I condone what did happen.
Yes.
Yes.
So going forward, just do a wrap up for me and then I'm going to come to you, Grace. Going forward, the total media blackout is not going to work. The police brutality is here to stay. How do we... That's what you're saying. That's what you're saying, Apollo.
No.
What do we do in 30 seconds? What should we do? Are there any lessons we can pick from this clip?
Okay, let me say it again.
Yes.
Ugandans need to unite.
Uh-huh.
Because this is not the only instance that we've had. Now, the politics of I belong to this association, let me tell you something. By the way, I'm a seasoned journalist and a senior journalist.
Yes.
But I do not belong to any of those associations. Because each of the associations, like I told you, has its own agendas. And
I thought the agenda would be your interest as a journalist.
Until we reach a stage to say that we are a united association of Ugandan journalists, and stop having briefcase kind of association for journalists, we shall have these things to stay. Let's get our eyes open and have a formidable association for Ugandan journalists and
I don't know, even if it means merging all the small associations.
Yes. You're loud and clear. Unity is your way forward. Coming to you, Grace, going forward, speak for the online people. Hashtag activism. We've had these conversations before. All these hashtags, free AJ stuff, free the Zone 9 bloggers. What is going to be the contribution of the bloggers to ensuring the safety and the guaranteeing of that those rights that we really want to pursue and enjoy? That's freedom of expression and also freedom from being assaulted by police officers.
One of us. There are so many instances where people go missing, so it's time that we start socializing within other to be able to create an association or a group that is trustworthy, that's very accountable, that does not have those individual politics that we are hearing about. This is a wake up call, and this means that by the time something happens in Canada, it means it's been happening and it's not been. Thank you, so let's support, and we should use this as an opportunity to join together.
Okay, thank you very much, Grace, for your insights, and thank you for making the time to be with us all the way from Nairobi. Okay, and thank you very much, Apollo, for your insights and for calling for all the Ugandan journalists to unite. Yes, we hope we'll have you again on the show. So you've heard from the journalists that I had on the show tonight. Their solution is not a media blackout. The solution is for Ugandan journalists to actually unite. So if we can unite, whether it's behind or in front of this particular cause, but can we use this particular tragedy, this particular case, and unite? I don't know whether that is possible, but you who is on social media can be able to tell us. Use the hashtags, journalism is not a crime, Ugandan journalists united, and of course, occupational hazards.